is flowing. This is working.
I've seen a lot of videos that call my attention about free energy water pumps. There are lots of videos about this, where some guys can build with a metal drum and some pipes this equipment, which work totally free energy without any external power source. Okay, this would be an awesome invention. Don't you think so? In this video, I'm going to build a model of this free energy pump. Will it work? Despite they haven't said anything about construction details, there are some comments about dimensions. The basic design uses a 55 gallons metal drum, which is placed 4 to 5 meters over the water source. There's an input pipe of 32 millimeters diameter, which starts from the water source and connects to the upper side of the drum. There's an outlet pipe, which should has more than 20 meters long and 63 millimeters diameter. This starts from the drum's bottom and ends on the fill. There's also a feeding bubble on the top. Apparently, this system can suction water 4 or 5 meters deep and carry it to a fill which is on a higher level, because the weight of the water inside the output pipe plus the weight of the water in the drum will pull and create a vacuum strong enough for rising water from the input pipe, since the input pipe is smaller and lighter. But is this statement true? There's another statement, which is about pressures, which says that it doesn't matter the weight of the water, but the column of water is the most important thing, regardless if this pipe is wider or thinner. This statement would say that the pressure on this side is higher than the pressure on the another side. Therefore, this won't flow in this direction. Let's face these statements each other. Water's weight and water's pressure. Less talk and more action. Let's build. Okay, then we are ready with this scale model of the free energy water pump. In this place, we have the source of water. This could be a river, a lake, or a water channel. This is the inlet pipe. They say this should be smaller, a diameter smaller than the outlet pipe. This is, I guess, 3 times bigger than this. This is our container, or this is representing the metal drum that they use. This is our feeding bubble. We already filled all this with water, with colored water, so we can see all the movements of the water, the flow, how it is flowing. First, we're going to make the first test. We're opening this bubble. We have to have this open as well. And we are doing the first test. We can see the level is going down, but we cannot see any water here. In fact, we can see the flow is going down, and the level is going down also, but
we don't have any flow of new water from the source. We can tell this point is higher than the level of the source, but it doesn't work this way. We're going to make a second test. Okay, this is the second test. This time, we're going to put this container, in a lower level than the source. And let's see what happens. We see the level is going down from the bucket. And now we can see we are making a suction here with our pipe, with suction pipe. It's working now. This is because the vacuum right here is strong enough for rise this water. If we go down, we can see the suction there is stronger and stronger. But if we go high, a higher level, the water won't flow here. We can see. Let's do it again. What happens if we do this? So, to conclude, we can see this system doesn't work for carrying water from a low level to a high level. This is a siphon. This is an ancient technology that it is useful for carry water from a high level to a low level. And this is the way it works. This is useful, but this is not a pump. A pump is a mechanism that help us to raise water from a low level to a high level. This doesn't work if you want to raise water.